AWA Championship Wrestling. The AWA presents the greatest stars in professional wrestling, bringing you the best in mat action. Welcome to AWA Championship Wrestling on ESPN. I'm Larry Nelson. I've asked Lee Marshall to join me. Thanks for being here.
A pleasure indeed to be with you tonight.
Let's talk about the action we had.
All right. We've got a young man who has now got a championship attitude. I'm talking about Ricky Rice. Always a quality wrestler, but now he's got that attitude he needs to take him all the way. I'm convinced of it.
We have bad company here, and they say they have a surprise for us. They're the World Tag Team Champions.
Well, I can't take anything away from them as far as being World Tag Team Champions, but they're being a little coy with this surprise. Maybe we'll find out about it tonight.
What about this giant from Denver, this Rocky Mountain Thunder?
Nobody knows anything about this big guy other than he's a big guy. He admits he doesn't even know how to wrestle. He calls it scuffling, and he loves what he's doing.
Whatever he does it devastatingly, and let's talk about the Rock and Roll Express. They're legends already, and they're still kids.
Yep, they're going for another world title. Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson, the Rock and Roll Express, making their AWA debut tonight.
Let's talk about the main event. Two legends, yep. Ray Stevens, joining Baron Von Raschke because of his feud with Soldat Ustinov and T. Joe Kahn. Now, you know what that's all about.
Yeah, you're talking about some of the all-time greats when you talk about Ray Stevens joining up with the Baron, and on the other side of the ring, T. Joe Kahn and Soldat Ustinov.
Baron Von Raschke has a lot to be angry about. They broke a board over his head. They've been trying to put him out of professional wrestling. Lee, it should be a war.
One man you don't want to mess with is the crippler, Ray Stevens. I guarantee that.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is one fall. There is a 10-minute time limit. Already in the ring from Kansas City, Missouri, weighing 245 pounds, he is Mike Richards. His opponent is from Edina, Minnesota. He weighs 237 pounds. He is Ricky Rice.
The Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm Rod Trongard, along with Lee Marshall, and we're going from Vegas to Vermont, from Malibu to Maui, from Louisville to London, and it's great to be with you again as Ricky Rice, one of the really up-and-coming young stars in the grueling world of professional wrestling, opens here against a young guy who is also making quite a name for himself, well-built Mike Richards out of Kansas City, Missouri, and it's Rice with a side headlock.
I'll tell you what, I have never seen Ricky Rice come out more ready for a match. I think this young man is absolutely going to light it up tonight.
And the expression on his face.
What a slam.
And now with a side headlock and a hip toss following that body slam, and Rice is really doing a number here on Mike Richards.
I don't know what's happened to Ricky Rice. He is absolutely on a mission. I've never seen him looking this good, Rod.
You talk about dedication. It's there in capital letters for this young man, an all-around athlete out of Edina, Minnesota, by the name of Ricky Rice. And, of course, great camera action, as always, here from the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada, with Rick Tucker and his floor crew doing a great job just like that in bringing it to you, to me, and to the entire world as Mike Richards fires away on Ricky Rice. Again, very great reaction by Ricky Rice as he got out of the way of the rush of Richards and was very quick to the side headlock and the hip toss and back to the canvas.
Look at him crank it up, Rod.
And both of these young men really, you know, spent a lot of time in the gymnasium, as you can just see the tremendous bodies that they both have and the fabulous condition that they're in. They have to be to make it here in the AWA. Whipped by Richard.
Sunset flip.
Watch. He may have it.
Oh, so close.
Referee Marty Miller, the third man in. Here's a small package. Mike Richards out of Kansas City, who is here just like Rice to make a name for himself and to head on for hopefully a shot at the championship of the world.
Headbutt.
A hard headbutt by Richards. Rice looked like he is hurt. Not only stunned, but he may indeed be hurt. Takes a big knee. Trying to shake the cobwebs. And hopefully that's all that it is.
Setting him up with a slam. Boom! Down goes Rice.
What?
Nobody home. This is a great opportunity for Ricky Rice to fire back now, Rod.
Look at him. Look at him and look at him go. Ricky Rice.
Elevation.
He's got Richards going. There's no time about it. There's the hook.
Again,
it's over. Look at that young man. Look at him good. Because you're going to be seeing a lot of him here in the AWA. Ricky Rice out of Edina, Minnesota, putting away Mike Richards.
What an outstanding display of wrestling ability by Ricky Rice. Now let's watch it again, Rod. Here comes Rice, just powering Mike Richards down to the canvas. And here comes Marty Miller for the 1-2-3. He's got him.
Tag teams from all over the world are coming after the best. Bad Company. Choshu Ricky, Mr. Saito from Japan, Rock and Roll Express, Nasty Boys, all of them want Bad Company. There's no way, boys. We're going to take care of business, and I'm going to tell you why.
When you watch today, we got a special surprise for you at the end of the show.
It's going to shock the wrestling world, nothing like you've ever seen before.
And this is a tag team match. One fall, there is a 10-minute time limit. Already in the ring from Longview, Texas, weighing in at 216 pounds, Jim Evans. His tag team partner from Tokyo, Japan, at 230 pounds, Ricky Ataka. Their opponents are the tag team champions of the world. From Honolulu, Hawaii, Pat Tanaka. From Thunder Bay, Ontario, referee at ringside, Rob Trongard and Lee Marshall.
Well, the one thing that is very obvious now is that that is not Bad Company. And that is not either Paul Diamond or Pat Tanaka.
Where's the... Give me that microphone, Larry. It's about time that the new AWA Tag Team Champs of the World were introduced properly. That's right, Daddy. But first I want to introduce myself. My name is Diamond Dallas Page, and I am the greatest professional wrestling manager in the universe. Not the world, the universe. And I was told, by my man, the Big K, the wisdom man of professional wrestling, that if I picked up these bad boys, that with my insight and wrestling ability, that I could take them to be the tag team champs of the world. And good God, the man was right. Shut up, man, I'm talking. So now, without any further ado, crank up that music. Here they come, the bad, bad, bad boys. At a combined weight of 435 pounds. Pat Tanaka and Paul Diamond. We're talking Bad Company. The AWA Tag Team Champs of the World. And we're talking B-A-double-D. Bad. Bad Company.
champions of the world, Bad Company and Pat Tanaka and Paul Diamond. And I will have to admit that that young lady, that beautiful young blonde lady who is now walking down the steps on the far side, I have not had the pleasure, but I look forward to it. Rod Tron got along with Lee Marshall here at the Showboat Sports Pavilion as Paul Diamond hooking up with Ricky Ataka to start this one out. It was, of course, March 17th here at the Showboat Sports Pavilion that Bad Company shocked the wrestling world by dethroning the Midnight Rockers, Marty Jannetty and Shawn Michaels, as Diamond ran Marty Jannetty into the post, split him wide open, hauled him into the ring, pinned him, and the referee then, who is the referee now, Gary DeRusha, apparently did not see what happened outside of the ring and counted three, and the championship belts changed hands, Lee Marshall.
You know, Rod, we do have to say that AWA President Stanley Blackburn had a chance to review the ugly, and I mean ugly, situation that you just described with Marty Jannetty being rammed into the post, a concussion. The young man took numerous stitches. At any way, the decision by Stanley Blackburn was that he would let the decision of the referee, Gary DeRusha, stand, and there they are, like it or not, the Royal Tag Team Champions.
Diamond Dallas Page, you saw, with the beautiful young lady.
Oh, what a clothesline.
Ricky Ataka, I have to double check to see if he still has a head on his shoulders. Diamond just about took it off. Holy cow. Diamond tags in Tanaka. Jim Evans has been unable to even get into this match. Jim Evans being Ataka's tag team partner. Sabat kick.
Tanaka is seeing stars. And look at Tanaka just almost laughing, Rod.
There's no two ways about that. Here's Diamond. Front face lock. He's going to take his man up. He has him.
Oh!
With a full front pile driver from 6.5 feet in the air.
And now just slapping and adding insult to injury to young Ricky Tanaka.
Hard body slam again by Diamond. Here comes Diamond looking for an elbow smash, but he doesn't get it. Ataka rolls out of the way.
He got it. He made the tag.
Jim Evans. Evans with a boot. Another boot. Evans with a whip on Diamond. Evans with a drop kick. He didn't get all of it. Got part of it. Didn't get any of it there.
Nope. And this gives Paul Diamond just a chance to work on the young Texan. Ah, flying shoulder tackle.
Big elbow smash that caught him and caught him flush. Uh-oh, let's see what they got in store here.
Here comes that finish.
The slingshot.
Ah!
The front pile driver down goes Evans again.
Lights out.
Tanaka, and it's all over. Wow. Say what you will about Pat Company. Paul Diamond and Pat Tanaka. They are tag team champions of the world, and you have just seen why.
The claw is coming. Soldat Ustinov, here it is. Whether it's Sudbury, Ontario, North Bay, Timmins, Las Vegas on the 14th, I'm coming after you. The claw is coming, and the Louisville Sleeper is going to be with me. So if you bring any of your comrades, T.J. O'Connor, the Sheik, help me take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the fair.
I love to draw. You know, it's really inspiring.
Proud to be right here at the AWA in Las Vegas. And we know what it's all about. We'd like to thank Chuck Berry for that new lick he taught us today. But what we're looking forward to is Bad Company and those world titles. That's what we're here for. All through Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina. That's where it's going to take place, or right here in this ring. Bad Company, you remember, brother. Woo! AWA is what it's all about. And five times world tag team champions. You're going to see right here. So, Gary, shine them belts up. We're coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is one fall. There's a 10-minute time limit. First of all, from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 241 pounds, he is Bill Anderson. His opponent is from Denver, Colorado. He stands 6'7" tall, weighs 337 pounds. He is Rocky Melton Thunder. Marty Miller is your referee. At ringside, Rod Trongard and Lee Marshall.
And look at that. Oh. Rocky Melton Thunder. I don't know what he's got in that gunny sack type. As you see him carrying it on his back there.
You know, I asked Rocky Melton Thunder, I said, what's in the bag? He said, I'm not telling. It's a surprise. Now look at him, he's just tying it up to the ring post there.
Is it alive?
Well, I don't know.
Well, I guess that's
I don't know that
to know and for us to find out.
I don't know that I'm the guy that wants to go up there and find out. This guy's just a monster, Rod.
Oh.
You know, he's not a real scientific wrestler. He just, well, as he says, he's just a scuffler. He likes scuffling. That's what he thinks this is.
He just goes out and gets it done.
That's it.
Anderson is finding that out in a hurry. Bill Anderson out of Los Angeles, California. Rocky Melton Thunder, 6'7". Yes, indeed, all 6'7". Just about drives Anderson through the turnbuckle and out of the ring. And now whips him. Oh! Oh!
Billy Anderson is hurt, Rod. No two ways about it.
Oh, Lord. Talk about herniating some discs. Something like that can certainly do it in a big hurry. And here's the clothesline by Rocky Melton Thunder. And how can Bill Anderson keep coming back and coming back? A very resilient young man, I'm sure. Okay, here it comes from Rocky Melton Thunder. Up and over with a suplex. Anderson crashes to the canvas. Rocky hooks the legs. And this one is history, folks. And Rocky Melton Thunder does it again. And we get another look.
He's just awesome, Rod. Look at him take over Bill Anderson.
Oh. And Anderson is 241 pounds. Now, seeing his prey in trouble, deep, deep trouble, he comes over and puts him away. And we'll be right back.
At Overget fans, we've got a spectacular main event coming up. Soldat Yusupov, the big Russian, went out and got himself a tag team partner from the Sheik's Army, none other than T-Jo Khan, to continue the feud with Baron Von Raschke. Now, that put Baron Von Raschke in a position where he had to get himself a partner. He got one of the greats of all time, five times a world tag team champion, none other than Ray the Crippler Stevens. Stevens and the Baron against T-Jo Khan and Soldat Yusupov. That's our main event coming up.
Everyone loves.
We're at intermission here at the Showboat in Las Vegas. We will get back to the live wrestling action in just a matter of minutes. But right now we have the opportunity to do something that you have responded to with your letters that I dearly love. We're going to get in the time machine, and we're going to go back and check out a Matt Classic from the AWA. Greg Gagne will be your host. It's my favorite segment. It's a lot of your favorite segments. Let's go back with Greg Gagne to the Matt Classic.
Well, here we go. 1982. Vern Gagne remained the world's heavyweight champion. Held the title longer than any other champion in the history of the AWA. At that time, he was facing his stiffest challenge of all times, 485-pound Jerry Crusher Blackwell. Blackwell had entered the AWA and had some tremendous victories over all the top opponents he had faced here in the AWA. So here we go, 1982, St. Paul Civic Center, Vern Gagne, World's Heavyweight Champion, versus Jerry Blackwell.
Oh, that breaks the grip. And a second one for good measure. He hurt him. Gagne hurt him. And a flying drop kick and another one. Three flying drop kicks in a row. Gagne wrestling on instinct. He doesn't really have it all together. Burns wobbling, looking around, So is Blackwell wobbly. Burn up from behind. The sleeper, the Gagne sleeper. Blackwell picks Gagne up. Gagne hanging on to the sleeper. Trying to do it. Blackwell still has a grip on Gagne. Joe Snyder holding the ropes away. Goes backwards into Byrne. Byrne, down like a wet noodle in the corner after 468 pounds, crush his body into the turnbuckles like a caterpillar tractor smashing a truck against a wall. Boom! That old ring sounded like a big bass drum. Blackwell coming down with a flying elbow smash. Goes for the bottom rope. Wants to get some height. And Gagne rolls out of his way. I'm not sure, but it looks to me like Blackwell's bleeding from the mouth or the nose. It sure looks like it. And he misses again. Gagne's got his marbles together enough to know to get out of there. Get out of Dodge when you gotta go. Byrne's stomach is really ailing him because of that tremendous vice-like pressure put on him by Blackwell. And Blackwell misses again. Does himself in. A cover by Gagne. One, two, three.
There you have it. Vern Gagne retaining his World's Heavyweight Championship over Jerry. 1975, we're going back to. For the Tag Team Championship of the World, Nick Bockwinkel and Ray Stevens, reigning champions, against Red Bastien and the one and only, the Crusher. So long until next week. We'll see you then.
This match is a tag team match. It is one ball. There is a 10-minute time limit. Already in the ring from the Samoan Islands, at 265 pounds, he is Samoan Joe. His tag team partner is from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Weighing in at 250 pounds, Tom Rocky Stone. Their opponents at a combined weight of 465 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Gibson and Ricky Morton, the Rock and Roll Express. Gary DeRusha is your referee. At ringside, Rod Trongard and Lee Marshall.
There they are. One of the hottest, if not the hottest, tag team in the world, and I emphasize world, ladies and gentlemen. Four-time tag team champions of the world, going for five. Robert Gibson and Ricky Morton, they're both out of Nashville. They are known as the Rock and Roll Express, and indeed they are big business. They draw record crowds wherever they go, and Tom Rocky Stone is going to open up against Robert Gibson.
The Rock and Roll Express already ranked as the number one challenger to Bad Company for the Tag Team Championship of the World. Here we go with the crisscross. Yo!
And a heel throw. Rocky Stone in trouble. The whip.
Oh, what a drop kick.
Morton bombs away on Rocky Stone. They're just exploding here at the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada. Okay, Morton tags in Gibson.
Samoan Joe trying to get into the action. Gary DeRusha chasing him back. Rocky Stone trying to fire back, and I think all the fight may be taken out of him by the Rock and Roll Express. Ah, knee drop.
These guys are nothing short of sensational. However, Gibson does get a hard right hand from this veteran out of New Orleans, Louisiana, or Baton Rouge, one or the other. Time Rocky Stone. Right now, Stone has tagged in Samoan Joe, and he finds himself on the wrong side of town. He's a big, rough, and tough customer. However, size means absolutely nothing to the likes of the Rock and Roll Express. And Ricky Morton is going to work right now on the 265-pound Samoan Joe. Who into the across the ring. Hard shoulder block here. Morton back and forth. Oh,
he caught him.
Samoan Joe wanted to work a backdrop. Morton saw it. Booted him.
Here comes Gibson.
And Gibson takes over, but he gets in the solar plexus that stops him in his tracks. Samoan Joe quickly tags in Rocky Stone, who drills Gibson with a right hand, pops him with another one, whips him across.
Oh, he was going to clothesline
him. He caught him in the solar plexus again, and then catches a drop kick himself. Gibson tags in Morton.
Rocky Stone thinks he may have made a big mistake by getting the Rock and Roll Express this upset.
But well, may, here's a big back.
Ho,
whoa, Morton. Body slam. Morton. Ricky Morton. To the top rope. Here he comes.
Airborne.
Oh! Stone. Eyes glazed, rolling to the back of his head. Gibson is tagged in, takes over the front face lock. A forearm smash, a whip by Gibson. Oh, a shot into the solar plexus, and he goes to work. Then on Samoan Joe, knee lift by Gibson. What a tag team combination. Side headlock, Gibson on Rocky Stone.
Oh, Stone's got him in the corner. Hopefully Gibson will... applying the punishment to Rocky Stone.
Is he ever? Stone kicks his way out, however. He's a tough young man from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Tom Rocky Stone. And the Midnight Express, Rock and Roll Express, make your fight.
Working. Double drop kick.
A double drop kick. Gibson with a cover. All of them.
That's it. I have got great news for the wrestling fans in Berkeley Springs, West Virginia, in Sudbury, Ontario, in Timmins, Ontario, and North Bay, Ontario. All the stars of the AWA soon coming to your city. Now, I want to reflect on something that happened not too long ago when Bad Company defeated the Midnight Rockers for the World Tag Team Championship belts. Still a lot of controversy and a lot of concern for good reason for Marty Jannetty. First, thrown over the top rope. That should have been an automatic disqualification. Secondly, rammed into the steel ring post. That, too, should have been a disqualification. The young man, Marty Jannetty, a concussion, a number of stitches. We are pleased to know that he is back in action. However, Diamond Dallas Page, the manager of Bad Company, says he will not allow his men to fight the Midnight Rockers. All right, let's go now to Marty Jannetty and Shawn Michaels to find out what they think.
First of all, the Midnight Rockers want to tell everybody in Sudbury, Timmins, and North Bay, Ontario, that we're coming, so look out. You know, Marty, I couldn't help but hear Bad Company out here earlier talking about all the teams that are coming after their World Tag Team titles. But it's the Midnight Rockers that are facing all these teams. It's the Midnight Rockers that are having to start from the bottom and go back up. Well, Bad Company, let me let you in on something. The Midnight Rockers did it once before. We've chased the World Tag Team titles for one full year, going from the bottom up. And we're ready to do it again. Bad Company, somewhere down the line, the Midnight Rockers are going to get a hold of you. And when they do, all hell's
going to break loose. Because you know it's not easy coming out here facing our fans, our family and friends, telling them week after week we were the best. and you made liars out of us. You took the title from us. The way you did it, run me into a post. Well, that's going to be forgotten. Because what's going to happen is we're going to get you. It's a big world. You can run for a long time, but eventually we're going to meet bad company. And I see already you're trying to hide behind a manager. You got this Dandy Diamond, whatever his name is. I'll tell you what, we've gone through managers before, bad company. You just keep one thing in mind. Like we said before, we're the team that gave you a chance. We're the team that made you, and we're the team that's going to break you.
Celebrate the Green Bay Packers for
just one fall with a 10-minute time limit. It is a tag team match. Introducing first of all from Singapore at 261 pounds, Tejo Khan. His tag team partner from the Soviet Union at 306 pounds is Soldat Ustinov. Their opponents, first of all, from San Francisco, California, at 268 pounds, Ray the Crippler Stevens. His tag team partner from Germany at 271 pounds, the Clawmaster, Baron von Kreschke. Marty Miller is your referee. At ringside, Rod Trongard and Lee Marshall.
From coast to coast, we're at the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm Rod Trongard, along with Lee Marshall and the Baron and his Louisville Slugger. Along with Ray the Crippler Stevens, are ready to take on Tejo Khan and Soldat Ustinov. And what a war this one should be from start to finish.
Yeah, the Baron's got that bout that he got from Kent Herbeck of the world champion Minnesota Twins. He calls it the Louisville Sleeper. And his partner, Ray the Crippler Stevens, you're talking about a guy that was seven-time U.S. champion, five-time world tag team champion. The combination of Baron von Raschke and Ray the Crippler Stevens is absolutely awesome. But they're in there against two guys from the Sheik's Army, Soldat Ustinov and the maniacal one, Tejo Khan. This would sell out any arena in the world, Rod.
Experience, of course, on the side of Ray the Crippler Stevens and Baron von Raschke. Youth and size on the side of Tejo Khan and Soldat Ustinov. But then not necessarily.
We've already got pandemonium. We've already got a melee in the ring. All four men in right as the bell rings. Whoa!
And it is Ray the Crippler Stevens with a backdrop on Soldat Ustinov after the Baron had chased Tejo Khan. I added up my figures incorrectly. Soldat and Tejo Khan indeed do have a weight advantage. 567 total pounds to 539 for Ray Stevens and Baron von Raschke. And when you get that kind of weight flying around, anything and everything can happen. Baron hooks up with Tejo Khan.
You got some beef in the ring tonight, Rod. Look at the Baron who's working over Tejo Khan. You talk about a score to be settled. The Baron would love to put this kid's lights out right now. Oh!
Big backdrop there by Baron. Oh. And a double shot to the eyes. First for Khan and then to Soldat. The Baron loves it, and so does the crowd.
Ray the Crippler Stevens now back to the Baron. You got to figure that the Baron wants a shot at Soldat Ustinov. After all, it was Ustinov that broke that big 2x4 right over the head of Baron von Raschke. And now Tejo Khan on the wrong side of the tracks, pal. Whoa!
Snap there here by Ray the Crippler Stevens. Ray, a real ring-wise veteran. He knows it all. He has been there so many, many times. Isn't anything I don't believe that anybody can do that'll surprise Ray the Crippler Stevens. He may be a half step slower than he once was, as you get a good look at him right there with that side headlock on Tejo Khan.
Well, wrestling fans remember Ray Stevens, as we said, five times world tag team champion with partners such as Pat Patterson and Nick Bockwinkel. And it's moves like that that made Ray the Crippler Stevens a champion. Here comes the Baron. Oh, look out.
T.J. Khan and Sold On Houston. Oh, yes.
Here's what we've been waiting for.
Of assault. Sold On Houston off Howler answers very, very quickly.
Oh,
and
what a move.
Baron with that boot as he came off the ropes and a quick cover here. But Baron kicks out. Absolutely fabulous camera work here at the Showboat, as always. As you see the shoulders, the gigantic shoulders of
Khan's got the tag rope. T.J. Khan's got the tag rope wrapped around the Baron.
Sold On Ustinov and T.J. Khan both doing a number on Baron von Raschke. And here is a whip, and here is a bear hug.
This could be a submission hold.
Indeed it could.
That big Soviet has got it locked on the Baron. Oh.
Rick Tucker and his camera crew, there's a close-up. Ooh, from ringside, Greg Fiorito operating that camera. And now you get a look from above with Dave Wilson and Kevin Robinson. And Steve Theodore is also at ringside with a handheld camera, bringing you all of the close-up action. As Baron von Raschke is all tied up.
He's got that
rope
tag rope again.
T.J. Khan.
Oh. That's like getting hit with a railroad tie when that big arm of Sold On Ustinov comes down. Look at him just walking the Baron for the slam.
Sold On.
He kicks
306 pounds of him trying to put the cover on Baron von Raschke. Right away. Oh. Bounces the head off the turnbuckle and now tags in T.J. Khan. Oh, the Baron is taking a pounding, a real pounding.
Yeah, this is part of the team. This is Uglier from the team of Ugly and Uglier. T.J. Khan. Ow, what a left.
You hear the chant.
T.J. Khan just working on the trapezius muscles now of Baron von Raschke. A very painful nerve hold, Rod.
Baron powering his way to his fate. There's an elbow to the solar plexus. Another one just under the heart. Baron shaking his head, covered here by T.J. Khan.
In the face by T.J. Khan.
T.J. 261 pounds.
Oh, yes!
Got caught with the big boot from the 271-pounder from Germany, Baron von Raschke. And now a tackle by T.J. to prevent the Baron from getting over to Ray Stevens. And here's a tag in of Sold On Ustinov.
Look at the size of Sold On Ustinov's feet, Rod. Those must be size 20s.
Huge is not the word. The man is huge. He is
nice reversal by Baron von Raschke. Hit cross. Down goes the big Russian.
But the Baron finding it difficult to follow up as he's taken a lot of punishment. And now again, it is Sold On. Grabbing the leg after tagging T.J. Khan. And they kept Baron von Raschke from getting to Ray the Crippler Stevens with a tag. And here again, a bear hug this time.
I don't know if he can apply it as hard as Sold On Ustinov, but it is such a tremendously painful hold, Rod. You simply cannot draw a breath when this hold is applied properly. Either the Baron has to try to break it by pushing himself into the ropes or somehow slip his arm in between his own body and the body of T.J. Khan. Pretty soon, he just will not be able to fully expand his lungs. Trying to draw some electricity. See, he's trying to get his hand between himself and T.J. Khan. That at least is going to take some of the pressure off. Excellent move by the Baron. Into a hip toss.
But you saw him miss the elbow smash. Mm. And that elbow going crashing to the canvas and numbing the arm. And now a tag in again. A Sold On Houston.
Right to the ribs.
Baron needs help. There's no two ways about it. He's got to get to Ray the Crippler Stevens. But Sold On Houston and T.J. Khan have been doing a great job of keeping him from that corner. sold on. Picks him up. Oh! Slams him in the center of the ring.
Ouch.
Off the rope he comes.
Gets up. Look at Ray Stevens just calling him. Come on. Come on, he's saying. Tag me in. Get me in there. I don't know if the Baron's got enough left in there to get over to Ray Stevens. He does. Here comes the Crippler. All right. Oh, what a right hand.
Ray Stevens doing his thing.
You're seeing pound for pound one of the toughest men ever to put on a pair of tights and get into a professional wrestling ring. Ray the Crippler Stevens is double tough. Atomic drop coming up.
There it is.
Got it. Oh!
Stevens covers. He got two. Oh.
And Ustinov came in.
And now the Baron is in. And now it is a free-for-all. As the Baron sends Soldat Ustinov out of the ring.
We may have a submission.
And Ray Stevens
Boston
has the Boston
crab.
Crab on T.J. Khan.
Ray Stevens
comes
is going. Look out!
Ustinov. Oh! And he crashes that flag pole. Again, this time it's over the head of Ray the Crippler Stevens. T.J. Khan sees Stevens over there. Stevens' leg is
on
the bottom rope.
Oh, no.
And I guess that doesn't make any difference. Maybe it has to be draped over that bottom rope. But Ray the Crippler Stevens is out like a light. He is absolutely out cold. Baron Von Raschke checking on his partner. As you saw Soldat Ustinov bring that Soviet flag and crash the pole that it is attached to across the head, the back of the head of Ray the Crippler Stevens and completely knock him senseless. And then it was for T.J. Khan to come to himself after being seriously pressured and punished and near submission in the Boston Crab, which Ray Stevens had on him. He was able to put it together. And there you see the Boston Crab, and you will see Soldat Ustinov coming. There he is. And there is that flag attached to that pole crashing across the back of the head of Ray the Crippler Stevens. Holy cow. Baron Von Raschke, you're looking at live action now. Baron Von Raschke checking with Ray the Crippler Stevens.
An absolute Pearl Harbor job, as you said, Rod. Ray the Crippler Stevens had T.J. Khan on the brink of submission. He locked in that Boston Crab. In came Soldat Ustinov. Hit Ray Stevens with that flag and that flag standard that was attached to. And to add even more insult, I thought Stevens had his foot over the rope. But apparently Marty Miller, the referee, didn't see it. As you mentioned, you can't call what you can't see. Ustinov and T.J. Khan, ugly and uglier, the winners.
It wasn't over the rope, it was under the rope, but there they go.
If you have 753-6888, call now.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think we just saw the beginning of an international war, but let me ask Lee Marshall for his comments. Who do you know that gets away with hitting Ray Stevens from behind?
I'll tell you who gets away with it. No one gets away with hitting Ray the Crippler Stevens. This man is a legend in this business, and he will be going for revenge.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was a shock. And speaking of a shock, Dallas Diamond Page all of a sudden showing up in control of bad company. What about that one?
Well, Diamond Dallas Page is internationally known as a wrestling manager, but I got news for you, Diamond Dallas Page. You've said that you will not sign a contract for your champions to meet the Midnight Rockers. I guarantee you, you're going to have to face the Midnight Rockers. There are great tag teams in the AWA. The Rockers, the Rock and Roll Express, the Nasty Boys, the newly formed team of Mondo Guerrero and Ricky Rice. You can run, pal, but you can't hide.
Speaking of that, ladies and gentlemen, we know. Now, you think it's a rumor. I'm willing to bet you that the AWA will be in Europe very soon, and that will be a world championship match. Bad company defending either against the Rock and Roll Express or the Midnight Rockers. That's my feel.
Well, I happen to know for a fact that in the European promoters trying to put this together, they would also like to get world heavyweight champion Kurt Hennig, and he's got a long list of challengers, including Greg Gagne and Wahoo McDaniel.
And the list goes on and on. I want to talk about the Rock and Roll Express right now. Ricky Morton, Robert Gibson. Our main event next week, stepping in against the Nasty Boys. You like them. I agree. I don't want them dating my daughter either, but they're tough.
I don't want them dating my daughter, and I don't want to have dinner with them. I don't want to hang with these guys. I've got a lot of respect for the Nasty Boys as a tag team. I think they are a legitimate team to challenge for the World Tag Team titles. Next week, as you said, Larry, they're going to be in the ring with the Rock and Roll Express. I've got to think that whoever wins the match between the Nasty Boys and the Rock and Roll Express has to be considered for a future title shot.
So do the Midnight Rockers, and ladies and gentlemen, it goes on and on. Join us next week for AWA Championship Wrestling.